You know, when I was in the service, I was single. So I identified myself as somebody's, I was still somebody's kid at that point. I was 20 years old and I was very, very young. You went as a mother, which had to be very different emotionally to prepare not only yourself, but your family for what you were going to do.
Yeah, it was hard. It was a hard decision because it actually was a decision to go. My name showed up on a list, and I could have waited to see if I got the call to go, but I didn't. I picked up the phone and said, this is where I want to go, which was Afghanistan. I want to go to the headquarters, and this is the time frame I want to go in. And so they accommodated that, found me a set of orders. It was hard because it was, for me, very professionally rewarding. It was very intriguing. I was very excited. I wanted the challenge, but obviously, you know, I knew on the personal side how hard it was going to be.
Obviously, 160 of America's daughters that have been out there.
I am definitely looking forward to the final tribute portion of the run, where I'll get to carry the photo of one of the women that we lost, Major Megan McClung. But there's various people along the way that I'll be running with that I'm also just really looking forward to spending some time with.
I feel like as women, we fight a lot of things in our lives that the guys sometimes don't always have to think about. No one's gonna judge them.
They're not the primary caregiver, so they don't have to make all the at-home preparations that you have to make as a mother leaving.
Right.
And I had male friends, peers in the Navy who were absolutely appalled that I was gonna go to Afghanistan. Mm-hmm. They're like, why would they make you go? You're a mother of six. And then I had female friends who literally stopped talking to me, like have not talked to them since. And then you get there and there's so few women there. And you know, you may not click with everyone that happens to be there. Mm-hmm. And it was an international environment and it was a NATO command. So you're dealing with not only different, you know, just different personalities, but now you're talking different cultures also. And depending on the flavor of the meeting, there would be times where I would be asked to cover my head. There were times when I was asked not to come in, period. Mm-hmm. You know, when they got to very high level religious leaders.
Right.
There were times when there were guests on the base where we were asked as women not to go outside in our PT clothes, you know, in our workout clothes.
Yeah.
Because there was too much skin exposed. So.
Right. You know, when you're over there and you said you got through by just believing nothing bad's gonna happen to me, I'm overdoing good. I'm in Afghanistan and I'm in Kabul. I'm here for good and nothing bad's gonna happen to me. And then Casey gets cancer.
Right.
Something bad happens to your child and you're not there.
Right, yeah. Yeah, that was...
Guilt-o-rama.
Oh, yeah. The guilt was, you know, I'm here doing something I love and, you know, look what's taken over my daughter's body, you know? Mm-hmm. I should have been there. You know, that, you know, no dad should have to deal with that himself.
That was pretty tough. Obviously, tough on my daughter. Tough on me, but tough on Nancy as well, considering she was on the other side of the planet. The Navy did a great job coordinating her return in enough time to actually sit down with our daughter together and tell her the news.
There was no time to even say goodbye and sort of close out that chapter in Afghanistan. You know, it was, I'm here and then I'm gone. And then I'm home, and all of a sudden, you know, we're sitting in CHKD, you know, right. In treatment.
And we should let folks know that Casey's doing well.
She is, yes. She just had over 2 years cancer-free. So yeah. She's, yeah, doing great.
When people hear about the Valor Run, it would be easy to assume, boy, Nancy must have had a close friend, must have lost a close friend or known somebody.
Yeah, I think people expect some, you know, very dramatic story mm-hmm. about a loss that mm-hmm. I have experienced. And, you know, I didn't, gratefully, I didn't. It really hit home when I went to the Women's Memorial and started looking through the book. And, you know, and it was the book of women that we'd lost in Iraq and Afghanistan, mm-hmm. you know, and you know, I kept going and going, and I'm like, I had no idea. We're doing this in memory of people, you know, and there is, you know, at least a sober moment, you know, in each leg of that run where they are on everybody's mind.
United States Army Lieutenant Colonel Jamie Leonard, 39, June 8th, 2013, Afghanistan. United States Army Specialist Enver Ault, 21, June 18th, 2013, Afghanistan.
I think it gives other women in the service a way to kind of rally around them, to bring ourselves together and kind of, you know, think about, hey, look at all the sacrifices that we are making. That is Major Megan McClung. I was talking about her yesterday in the email that I had got from her mother and how much that meant to me, especially yesterday when I was really struggling, you know, when she's like, I know Meg is running alongside of you. I can't imagine the hole in the lives of so many families where their child or their mother or their wife went away and there was never a final chance to say goodbye. In some cases, probably not even great understanding of what exactly happened. And, you know, it's a big hole in a lot of people's lives.
Yeah, it's been an absolute honor to do this and to get the support from so many people. God bless you. God bless the United States.
That's really what I hope people understand out of this, is that, you know, there's people all over the place who lost somebody, so you and I can sit here and have the freedom to discuss all this.
Absolutely.